It is a good day to be in the Capitol. It is a good day to be a member of the House of Representatives. It is a good day to be celebrating Black Maternal Health Week right here in our Capitol with Black mamas, with Black birthing folks, with Black families, with Black midwives, with Black doulas, with Black birth workers from across our Commonwealth. I am so proud to represent the 24th Legislative District in the city of Pittsburgh. This is where I became an activist, an organizer, and a leader for reproductive justice. Reproductive justice that would put me on my path, and that path was always centering Black maternal health. For the past 20 years, I and others have been fighting for the human right to control our bodies, our sexuality, our gender, our work, our reproduction, and the ability to form our families. But I am grateful for this week. I'm grateful for Black Mamas, I'm grateful for Black Mamas Matter Alliance, who had the foresight to create a week like this that is bringing us all together in our communities and in our capitals to bring the change that is needed. So April 11th through the 17th is about amplifying the love, the joy, and the pain. The pain that Black mamas and birthing folks experience when they want to bring children into the world. There is hope and there is fear. But in this legislature and in this session, we are sharpening our vision for Black maternal health and to bring it to its end in our Commonwealth. We will be bold in our policy and our legislation until it becomes a reality. Until it becomes a reality. Because when we eliminate disparities for Black mamas, we improve the health of all mamas in this Commonwealth. When we support low-income mamas and birthing folks, we are helping all mamas and birthing folks across this Commonwealth. This is what we have to do together. But we are here to also pass legislation. We're ready. We're ready for Medicaid to cover doula care services. We're ready to continue the great work that the Biden administration has done in codifying, making postpartum care permanently extended from 60 days to 1 year. We're ready for that. We're ready to ensure that parents and mamas and birthing folks have parental leave, that they have the mental health support. But you know what also would help Black mamas and birthing folks? Equal pay, but not poverty wages. You know what helps Black mamas and birthing folks is raising the minimum wage. You know what would help is eliminating all forms of violence against Black mamas and birthing folks, most of which they experience while they're pregnant. You know what would help Black mamas? Access to quality, affordable health care before they become pregnant, while they're pregnant, after they give birth, up to at least a year. You know what would help Black mamas? Is fighting for our environment and against climate change. You know what would help Black mamas? Making sure that there are healthy foods available in their communities. You know what would help Black mamas is making sure that we all have a clear vision about eliminating Black maternal mortality and always centering Black maternal health care. So that is our charge today as legislators, as advocates, as allies, as birth workers. This is our commitment to the Black mamas and birthing folks across this Commonwealth, because it changes today. We're no longer going to stand for black mamas in this Commonwealth to die at more than 2 times the rate of white women. We're no longer going to stand for that. So y'all ready to fight for black mamas and birthing folks? Are you ready to fight? Are you ready to protect and advocate for black mamas and birthing folks? No matter where they are or where they live or who they love or how much money they would make, we all deserve to be able to bring children in the world. Y'all ready to fight for black maternal health? Yeah. Are you ready to fight for black maternal health? This is an incredible day. This is one of the first times that we are doing this as a caucus, and this is work that we will continue beyond today. So I want to bring it to a close and say thank you to Rep. Gina Curry, the co-chair of the Women's Health Caucus. I want to thank our other co-chair of the Women's Health Caucus, Rep. Daly, who is here with us. I want to thank the inimitable Rep. Donna Bullock, who is the chair of the Legislative Black Caucus. I want to thank the Women's Commission. I want to thank all our speakers, especially our second lady, Blair Holmes Davis, who hails from my county, Allegheny County. And of course, the amazing and incredible Dr. Ayla Stanford. We're here because of work that she did on her back during one of the worst times in this Commonwealth. She made a way for us to be healthy and well, especially for black mamas and birthing folks, when nobody else would. She is a shining example of who I hope to be as a legislator and be bold and innovative and get the job done. Can we give it up for Dr. Stanford? So thank you to all my colleagues who are here. I've been on them all week about being here. And they showed up and they showed out because black mamas matter. Black mamas matter. Black mamas matter. Black mamas matter. So that is the rallying cry for today and as we go forward. And I'm going to bring up Rep. Curry one more time to talk to you about the rest of the day. Thank you so much and happy Black Maternal Health Week.